just give love and never give love. You better let love deep love.
I know it's old, and yet I know
I can't get you
out of my heart.
Thank you. Thank you. President Johnson, all is in readiness to begin the exercises for the 140th anniversary commencement exercises at the University of Rio Grande Community College.
I gratefully acknowledge the participation of the faculty and staff, your special efforts, and those of the faculty marshals and the commencement committee that have brought us to this particular moment. On behalf of the Rio Grande community, thank you, Grand Marshal Matura. Good afternoon. Thank you, Grand Chorale and Symphonic Band. Welcome to the commencement ceremonies for the University of Rio Grande and Rio Grande Community College. This is a beautiful day, and I welcome everyone that is here in body, and there are many people here with us in spirit. There are also many people watching us and participating today from around the world. This ceremony is being streamed live to many people who would otherwise not be able to participate. So welcome to everyone that is joining us wherever you may be. To begin today's celebration, we ask that you remain standing as the Grand Chorale leads the audience in singing the national anthem and Chaplain Finch gives the invocation.
founder's prayer, which will be given as today's invocation, is a reminder of all who have come before us at Rio Grande. Red and white carnations decorated on our stage in their honor. And at the conclusion of today's ceremony, the flowers will be taken to Calvary Cemetery and laid on the graves of our founders. Let us pray. Dear God, help us now for this brief moment to focus our thoughts on Rio Grande and on all the people over the years who are responsible for its founding and nurturing, sustaining the institution through good times and bad times has not always been easy, but it has been worthwhile. The sacrifices made by some have yielded rewards for many. We know that Rio Grande has influenced the lives of many people and that its impact extends far beyond the physical campus into the broader community, the state, the nation, and even the world. Most importantly, we recognize the indomitable spirit of Rio Grande fills the hearts and minds of the people who collectively comprise the institution. Regardless of where they are, we pray the institution will continue to make a difference in each of their lives. Finally, we ask for a special blessing of each student who has spent time here, on each faculty and staff member who has devoted part of his or her life to the success of the institution, and on all of the individuals who have supported the work and the dream that is in Rio Grande. All of this we ask in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, and you may be seated. At this time, I would like to present the members of the President's Party and our honored guests. Thank you for holding your applause until all of these introductions have been made. Individuals who are being introduced, please remain standing until all introductions have been made. First, I would like to go off script a little bit. I'd like to ask a very important group to stand and remain standing through all of these introductions. This is the group that is the lifeblood of this institution. It's their service, it's their sacrifice, and it's their excellence that absolutely undergirds the foundation and the strength of this institution. At this time, I would like to ask our faculty to stand. We're already breaking the rules. I think we said don't clap until this was all said, but they're too wonderful and too important not to do that. I'd like to ask our staff. They are scattered around in many locations. Many are already standing, but I would like to ask the members of our staff, the employees, in addition to the faculty that are already standing, to please stand. I'd like to recognize Dr. Alice Dahowski, Chair of the University of Rio Grande Board of Trustees, our commencement speaker, Megan Wise, Miss Ohio USA 2016, and Mr. Jack Finch, alumnus, trustee, and university chaplain, Mr. Larry Kidd, Chair of the Rio Grande Community College Board of Trustees, Mrs. Sean Saunders, former Rio Grande Community College Board Chair, and Dr. Richard Sachs, our Provost, who will present the candidates for the Master's, Bachelor's, and Associate degrees later in the program. Also joining us today for the ceremony are Mr. Silas Pulliam, our Student Senate President, and Ms. Megan Barnes, Alumni Council Chair. Both will speak later in the program. Among our graduates are members of our own faculty and staff, as well as the family members of several employees. Please allow me to recognize our staff first who will be graduating. Susie Fitch, Cherokee Gilkey, Jay Godot, Carrie Napora, and Jessica Lee White, and family members of our employees, Charlene Arrowwood, Nathan Clagg, Claire Dotson, Katie Godot, Adam Hollingshead, Max Huston, Lauren Mitchell, John Rexrode, Leah Simpson, Kiri Swan, Emily Thomas, Eric Colley, and David Kinnaman. Will the members of the University and Community College Boards of Trustees that are seated in the front please be recognized as a body? Thank you to everyone that is standing and has been introduced. Over the course of the year, many of our Rio Grande family have experienced great joys, which have culminated into the successes that we celebrate today. But the year also saw the loss of two members of our Rio campus family. Emily Cooper, nursing student and assistant volleyball coach, and Professor Emeritus Joanne Ford. As recognition by her fellow faculty, they have draped Dr. Ford's gown over her empty chair. Please join me in a moment of silence to honor these two outstanding individuals, as well as other members of the Rio family whom we have lost this year. Thank you. At this time, I have the privilege of conferring the degree of Doctor of Public Service, honoris causa, upon Mrs. Shawn Saunders, former chair of the Rio Grande Community College Board of Trustees. Dr. Sachs will cloak Mrs. Saunders with a hood. Will Chair Saunders please come forward? At this time, I would also like to ask Rio Grande Community College Board Chair, Mr. Larry Kidd, to read a resolution honoring Mrs. Saunders.
Whereas Ms. Shawn Saunders has concluded her role as Chair of the Rio Grande Community College Board of Trustees, effective June 29, 2015, after holding this position for a term of 2 years. Whereas Ms. Saunders has effectively led Rio Grande Community College Board of Trustees and staff with steady stewardship and great poise. And whereas Ms. Saunders has been a unifying leader in the work with the University of Rio Grande Board of Trustees on items such as the Presidential Search Committee and the Instructional Services Contract negotiations. And whereas Ms. Saunders has shown dedication to Rio Grande Community College and the residents of Gallia, Vinton, Meigs, and Jackson counties with the service of her time and talents in this voluntary role. Therefore, let it be resolved that the Rio Grande Community College Board of Trustees honors Ms. Shawn Saunders for her work as Chairman of the Board of Rio Grande Community College. Thank you.
At this time, would Dr. Dahowski and Dr. Sachs join us for the presentation of degree and hooding. Sean E. Saunders, proud Gallia County resident, worthy trustee, and honored friend of Rio Grande. You were installed as a member of the Rio Grande Community College Board of Trustees in 2008, and for the last 8 years, you have served Rio Grande faithfully as trustee, co-chair of the Joint Academic Affairs Committee, Joint Board Commission member, and board chair. As chair, your commitment to the well-being of Rio Grande did not waver. Your leadership has strengthened the foundation of the institution through fostering the working relationship between our two boards. You gave the institution the full benefit of your time, talents, and passion for Rio Grande. For the dedication you have shown to the University of Rio Grande and Rio Grande Community College and all of its stakeholders, we thank you and honor you today. It is my pleasure to present Sean E. Saunders for the conferment of the degree of Doctor of Public Service, honoris causa. Mrs. Saunders, by the authority vested in me by the University of Rio Grande Board of Trustees, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Public Service, honoris causa, with all of the rights and privileges pertaining thereto, and cause you to be cloaked with a hood. We also present to you a diploma so that all may know that you, Sean Saunders, do merit the honor given to you this 7th day of May, 2016. Good afternoon. Boards of Trustees, Chairman Kidd, Chairman Dukowski, Dr. Johnson, faculty, and distinguished guests, and our special guest, Miss Ohio. Thank you for this great honor. It's a blessing to have the opportunity to serve the students of Rio Grande. We are a fortunate community college and we are fortunate to have a community college and university working together to offer a broad range of programs. Both boards work diligently alongside the faculty and administration to ensure you receive a quality education. Congratulations to our graduates. We are proud of your accomplishments. May you look back on your time with sincere happiness. Thank you. It is my pleasure to introduce Megan Wise, Miss Ohio USA 2016. Megan is a 2008 graduate of Gallia Academy High School, and she earned a bachelor's degree from the University of Rio Grande in elementary education in 2012. She holds a master's degree from Concordia University in Chicago in educational leadership. And she's a first grade teacher at Meigs Elementary in Middleport. You may read more about Megan in your printed program, but I think that you are very much in store for great words of advice and encouragement for us all. Introducing Megan Wise.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you so much for having me today. I'm extremely honored to be here speaking to you on your commencement. Not very many girls in my shoes get to do something as prestigious as this. First of all, I want to tell you congratulations. You made it. All of your hard work, your dedication, and the occasional sleepless nights have finally paid off. I hope you feel an immense amount of pride today. The education that you have received is something that you will hold dear to your heart for the rest of your life. I truly believe that an education is more valuable than gold. My passion for education runs so deep that I decided to become a teacher. I also graduated from the University of Rio Grande in 2012 with my degree in elementary education and in educational leadership with a master's degree from Concordia University of Chicago. And I currently teach first grade at Meigs Primary School. For some of you, obtaining your degree today may not have been the easiest of road. Maybe you decided to go back to school later in life. Maybe you are balancing athletics, a family, or even a job. Or maybe you were like me and it took you a little while to finally decide on a major. I once thought that I wanted to go into the medical field until I started actually doing hours in a hospital. And I found that I fainted at the sight of everything. So I had to change. But overcoming these kinds of obstacles make our accomplishments all the more sweet in the end. Today, I want to talk to you about two things. The first is the importance of perseverance, and the second is about having a dream. As a teenager, I loved modeling. I attended classes on Saturdays in Columbus to learn everything that I could about the industry, from stage presence to makeup tricks and how to go on casting calls for designers. At 18 years old, I entered the Miss Ohio Teen USA pageant. I loved being on stage and modeling, so I figured that this would be the perfect fit for me. That was my first time competing at a large state-level pageant, and I was fortunate enough to have placed third runner-up. After my experience, I fell in love with pageantry. I loved the excitement of being on stage, the glamour of a live event, and the purpose of women advocating for others. It became my big dream to be Miss Ohio USA and competing at Miss USA. It was a long and challenging road to achieve my goal, with many victories of placing in the top five consistently, and even placing as first runner-up 2 years in a row. You know that old saying, always a bridesmaid, never a bride. Well, that was me. I did not win the title on my second attempt, or on my third, or even my fourth. It took me 9 years to finally achieve my goal, and on my final year of age eligibility, I won the title of Miss Ohio USA. During my journey, I worked tirelessly to improve and never gave up on my dream that I had made for myself. Like with any big goal, I had my fears and my doubts. There were times that I wondered if I was even good enough to win. I would hear critiques like, "Why even bother? Those things are rigged." Or, "You're from too small of a town. You don't have the same connections as people from bigger cities." But I knew in my heart that I was capable, so I kept persisting and I kept working. When my name was called as the winner, it was the most surreal moment of my life. Looking back now, it's hard for me to even believe that I was considering quitting and giving up on my dream. But we are all faced with those moments in life, and trials where we question our passion and question our ability to proceed. Today, we live in a world filled with instant gratification, and that sometimes distracts us from putting in the work to achieve our goals. However, I can tell you, nothing worth having is ever easy. I learned a lot about myself during those years of competing, but for the most part, I learned that it's okay to fail. It's okay to fall short a few times when striving towards a goal. But it's never okay to stop trying just because it gets hard. When I first began competing, a dear friend told me, "Your toughest competitor will be the woman you face every day in the mirror." At 18 years old, I did not understand the magnitude of her advice. But it has been the truest thing that I've ever been told. I believe that we all have a big dream in our hearts. It's our one true passion. It's that something that we can really envision ourselves doing. However, it's becoming increasingly rare that people actually pursue their big dream. We're often held back by fear, doubt, or the opinion of others. Even when the opportunity presents itself, people will often turn down their big dream in order to not risk leaving their comfort zone. But today, I want to encourage all of you to go for it. I want you to envision a life that you love and stop at nothing to achieve it. Because in life, obstacles cannot stop you. Your circumstances cannot stop you, and not even other people can stop you. You are the only one that can stop you from achieving your dreams. As you're sitting here today, waiting to receive your degrees, take a second to appreciate the magnitude of this moment. As graduates, you too are shining examples of hard work and dedication. I want to encourage you to keep working, never place a limit on yourself, and always remember the wise words of Walt Disney: if you can dream it, you can achieve it. I want to thank you all for having me today. I wish you the very best of luck in your future. Thank you.
Thank you, Megan, for your words of advice and for your mark on this world as a Rio alum. We're very proud of you. On June 5th, we have an opportunity as a Rio family, and there are over 2,000 of us here today and many others watching, we have an opportunity to support Megan. Fox will broadcast the Miss USA pageant at 7 o'clock live. Glad you like live events. We really have that opportunity. Typically in the pageant, viewers can vote. And she tells me that you never know if they're going to do it or not, but we need to be ready if they do. So let's show our Rio pride on June 5th at 7 o'clock as we celebrate Megan's accomplishments and her dreams. Graduates, the time has come now to honor you individually by awarding your degrees. Dr. Richard Sachs, our provost, will present the candidates for the respective degrees. First, the candidates for the master's degree will be hooded and presented their degrees. Thereafter, the candidates for the baccalaureate degree and then the candidates for the associate degree will be introduced and presented their degrees. Dr. Sachs?
Madam President, I have the honor to present the candidates of the class of 2016 for the conferment of the master's degree. The candidates have successfully fulfilled the requirements of the University of Rio Grande for their degrees. Their names appear in the commencement program. Will the candidates for the master's degree please stand and remain standing until all master's degrees have been conferred by the president of the university?
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the University of Rio Grande and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I hereby confer upon you, including those in absentia, the master's degree with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the candidates for the master's degree come forward to receive their diplomas from Dr. Alice Dachowski, Chair of the University Board of Trustees, and I will cloak them with a hood. Their names will be read by Deans Dr. Donna Mitchell and Dr. David Lawrence. Dr. Mitchell, Dr. Lawrence.
Rainey Caitlin Brixen. Craig Michael Davies. Jack Robert Marchant. Joseph Michael Toronto. Scott Mark Wells. Megan Renee Edwards. Kaylee L. Walk. J. Farrell Godot. Carolyn Gray Napora. Alice Newberry.
Congratulations.
Cheryl Renee Egner.
Congratulations.
Pamela Riggs Patterson. Lindsay Marie Pinder.
Madam President.
Dr. Sachs.
I have the honor to present the candidates of the class of 2016 for the conferment of the baccalaureate degrees. The candidates have successfully fulfilled the requirements of the University of Rio Grande for their degrees. Their names appear in the commencement program. Will the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees please stand and remain standing until all of the baccalaureate degrees have been conferred by the president of the university.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the University of Rio Grande and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I hereby confer upon you, including those in absentia, the baccalaureate degree, with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. To further signify that you have received your baccalaureate degree, you may now move the tassel of your graduation cap from the right to the left.
Will the baccalaureate degree graduates come forward to receive their diplomas from Dr. Dahowski, as their names are called by Dr. Mitchell and Dr. Lawrence.
Luis Antonio Filho. Joseph C. Bevins, cum laude. Connor Staley Zingarelli. Dempsey Bell Roop, cum laude. Allison Waddell. Claire Marie Smith. Emily Ray Roop. Samantha Prophet, magna cum laude.
Congratulations. Best wishes.
Joshua D. Goodall, cum laude.
Congratulations on your honors. Very proud.
Congratulations.
Adam Matthew Hollingshead, summa cum laude. Nathaniel W. Johnson, Sr., summa cum laude. Kendall Dale Madison. Matthew Akers. Harris Morris, magna cum laude. April Dawn Davis, cum laude. Joey D. Hannig. Stephanie Legg, summa cum laude. Jacqueline L. Lau, summa cum laude. Amelia M. Maxson, magna cum laude. Haley Marie Myers, summa cum laude. Samantha Ann Myers, cum laude. Judith Ann Searles, cum laude. Gwendolyn Kathleen Rose, cum laude. Brittany Leanne Beeman. Wendy Lee Wade. Robert Foudy. Carla J. Garn, magna cum laude. Christopher Adam Hill, magna cum laude. Courtney Aaron Young, summa cum laude. Morgan Elise Daniels, summa cum laude. Jamie Renee Saunders. Samantha Hammond Klingemann, cum laude. Rebecca Sue Newell Lipscomb, cum laude. Colby Robert Lee, magna cum laude. Betsy Jane Schramm, magna cum laude. Kimberly Carol Costello. Aaron M. Landrum. Andrew Lawrence. Sarah B. Boner, summa cum laude. Cody James Fox, cum laude. Adrian Michelle Wolfe. Rex A. Bays. Bradley S. Cordell. Sean M. Gebhardt. Jacob David Manning, cum laude. Jordan Danielle Maxwell. Kelsey Ashton Severs. Casey Crow. Melissa Dickerson, magna cum laude. Trevor D. Grant. Harley N. Adler, cum laude. Dwayne Bazemore, Jr. Kevante L. Black. Tanya M. L. Edwards. Susie Fitch. Mariah N. Garrett. Maldueno Enrique Gonzalez Morillo. Nathi Kambutho, magna cum laude. Catherine Nicole Rogers. Kimberly Lynn Rollins, cum laude. Julie Ann Tillis. James Robert Wallace, cum laude. Jacob Wheeler. Ian Patrick Dressel. Micah Lynette Walter. Abby Elizabeth Loffing. Taylor Danielle Newland, magna cum laude.
Samantha D. Smart. Heather C. Backer, magna cum laude. Stevie Beth Brown. Ada Marie Deal. Daniel Stephen Frazier, magna cum laude. Ariel K. Roeder. Taylor Ahrens. Alexandria Marine Branch. Brendan Gordon Crawley. Kendall Emmanuel Ray Sean Freeman. Davon Joyner. Anthony T. Niddle. Edward Francis Musi Jr., magna cum laude. Jessica Rose Northup, cum laude. Kyle W. Sanborn, cum laude. Bobby Lee Sizemore. Justina M. Taylor Lebutsky. Emily Dawn Thomas. Candace J. Jeffers. Trinity Kimes. Aaron Shante Polson, cum laude. Pamela Cross. Marcia Ann Eggers, magna cum laude. Lois Ann Miller, magna cum laude. Raylene N. Fitzpatrick, cum laude. Marty Poling, cum laude. Roberta Sue Irvin. Marcy L. Woods. John Rexroad. Cody Lee Riffle, cum laude. Joshua Wiley. Kenneth Michael Myers, magna cum laude. Aaron Lee Fletcher, cum laude. Shamika Renee Armstrong, cum laude. Dreema L. Bowman, cum laude. Haley Gwynn. Megan Mariah Hayslip. Jennifer W. Mullins. Alexandra Phillips. Tammy J. Tribby. Jessica Lee White, cum laude. Rebecca L. Conley. Travis Scott Elliott, cum laude. Derek Scott Harold. Tyler Mitchell Hayslip. Leanne Marie Hittle. Joel Johnston. Alicia Gail Kirby. Molly Lynn Meeks, cum laude. Charlotte Ann Workman, cum laude. W. Fred Workman.
Madam President,
Dr. Sachs.
I have the honor to present the candidates of the class of 2016 for the conferment of the associate degrees. These candidates have successfully fulfilled the requirements of Rio Grande Community College for their degrees. Their names appear in the commencement program. Will the candidates for the associate degree please stand and remain standing until all of the associate degrees have been conferred by the president of Rio Grande Community College.
By the authority vested in me, by the Board of Trustees of Rio Grande Community College, and upon the recommendation of the faculty of the University of Rio Grande, I hereby confer upon you, including those in absentia, the associate degree with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the associate degree graduates come forward to receive their diplomas from Mr. Larry Kidd, Chair of the Rio Grande Community College Board of Trustees, as their names are called by Dr. Mitchell and Dr. Lawrence.
Claire Patricia Dotson. John Anthony Sipple, Jr., with distinction. Aaron Hale. Max Joseph Houston. Sarah Lynn White Powell. Sandra. Amber Dawn Zublik. Tracy Dawn Beaver. Jennifer Renee Cade. Catherine Oschel. Olivia Faith Poling, with distinction. Crystal Ann Winchester. Amanda Baker, with distinction. Kimberly Lynn Day, with distinction. Rhonda Gay Fortner, with distinction. David Kinneman. Jacob David Cruz. Victoria L. Daniels. Andrea Marie Edelman. Corey Fisher. Victoria Lee Freeman. Troy Anthony Gant. Matthew T. Hodge, with distinction. Zachary M. Bowden. Samuel William Carlton McCall. Leah Simpson. Stephen M. Stricker. Thayla Aileen Stump. Rose Ann Travis. Casey Alexis Turley. Christian J. Wirtz. Jessica Nicole Atkinson. Tara Michelle Ferris. Bobby Leanne Harris. Chelsea Nicole Leach. Marlene K. Moore. Miranda Renee Pettit. Abigail Lynn White. Anna Will. Julie Grace. Andrea E. Hunt, with distinction.
Megan R. Lamb. Amber N. Lambert, with distinction. Lauren Elizabeth Mitchell. Kiana C. Osborne, with distinction. Marissa May Radcliffe, with distinction. Brooke Ryder, with distinction. Kelsey N. Risner, with distinction. Peggy D. Shiflett, with distinction. Lacey A. Stanford, with distinction. Lacey Michelle Stocker. Courtney N. Thomas. Aubrey R. Thornsberry. Taylor Ann Weaver, with distinction. Andrea N. Wines, with distinction. Jessica Nicole Dill. Dawn Elizabeth Helton, with distinction. Emily Catherine Hussle. Herbert A. McIntyre, with distinction. Morgan Alexis McMillan. Rachel Danielle Payne, with distinction. Shane Shepherd. Cheyenne Dawn Smith. Victoria Lynn Wolf. John Nathan Daniel Bowling. Andrew Brown. Bethany M. Carmen Lydell. Olivia R. Glassburn. Brittany M. Nelson. Elizabeth A. Hours. Chelsea Preston. Kaylin R. Spradling, with distinction. Ashley Lynn Huffman. Rachel Elizabeth Bell. Chelsea Brown. Beta May Schrader counts. Beta May Sharanda counts. Elizabeth Ann Crimes. Erica Jane Dow. Kayla D. Dow. Brittany Durst, with distinction. Casey Pearl Eblen, with distinction. Jessica Brianne Fisher. Ashley A. Foster. Katie Godot. Brittany Shaylin Greenleaf. Rebecca Elizabeth Paul with distinction. Brooklyn Dawn Carlos. Abby Lynn Harris. Melissa L. Hemsley. Alexandria Marie Kuhn with distinction. Aiden McCoon. Hannah Putney. Donna M. Seymour. Marcy Colleen Sigmund. Melissa Wooten. Kylie Ray Armbruster. Charlene Arrowwood with distinction. Molly Baldridge. Amber Nicole Breach. Morgan Leanne Brumfield. Kathleen M. Brush. Kayla Elizabeth Burns. Jessica Joy Beth Kales. Erin Elizabeth Pasto. Catherine Lynn Kinesi. Danny K. Christman. Maggie Elizabeth Flagg with distinction. Nathan R. Flagg II. Alexandra Gabrielle Clark. Madison Combs. Leslie Ann Crockett. Crystal Davis with distinction. Catherine Elizabeth Durr. Felicia Donaldson. Takesha M. Edwards. Delilah Avina Fish. Rebecca Danielle Fortner. Sherry Lynn Fredericks. Riza Garrett. Caitlin Marie Gillum. Danielle Gruber with distinction. Kelly Christine Harless. Jennifer Harrison. Jennifer Marie Herzog. Cassandra Holly with distinction. Victoria Suzanne Howe. Nicole Hunt. Carly Elizabeth Jackson. Derek A. Lawhorn. Natalie Shalane Lau. Caitlin Lowry. Stacy Lynn Masters. Stephanie Dawn McKenzie. Amy Beth Miller. Crystal Moore. Allie Morris. Brittany Danielle Nance. Mary Kay Napier. Vicki L. Patrick. Sarah Ann Payton Vaness. Jennifer J. Potts. Tara Ramsey. Laura Jane Rollins Moore. Anissa Lynn Reffitt. Cheryl Ann Ruggles. Rebecca K. Rudd. Lacey A. Sayer. Heather Simpkins. Cassandra Lynn Marie Smith. Nick Spur. Cassie L. Thompson. Gina Suzanne Webb. Vanessa Leanne White. Michaela Jo Wickline. Lolita A. Woodward. Amber Lee Woods with distinction. Aaron Lee Wright. Julian Young with distinction. Adam Christopher Owens. Ryan Wynn. Mackenzie Sellers. Sean Dylan Levins. Christopher Delaney. Derek Adam Hartman. Ted Hollingshead. Stephanie Mullins. Larry E. Patrick Jr. with distinction. Jess Woodyard. John Russell Ragland. Daniel Kevin Spencer. Michael Ted Bailey with distinction. Colton Keller Bostic. Brian Kahn. Trenton J. Deem. Philip Blaine Donovant. Mason James George. Tim Stearns. Timothy Ryan Swan with distinction. Letitia Paige Nichols. Jayla Nicole Clark. Ashley Michelle Farrell. McKenna Paige Kaiser. Zachary Kane McKinney. Odessa K. McManus. William Eric Zinn. Robert L. Berry II. Stanley W. Bowman II. Eric Coley. Thomas E. Holly. Natasha Martin.
I know. Rain is coming, so we're moving quickly. I'd like to introduce two great and important leaders. Silas Pulliam, our student Senate President, if I can get that out. That may be a tongue twister. And Megan Matura Barnes, a graduate in 2002, representing our Alumni Council. As Silas and Megan come up, I'd like to say that Silas has served this year with energy, a contagious attitude and a determination to make a difference as a strong voice for our students. Thank you for speaking today.
Woo, Silas!
All right, I'll try to make this a little quick since the rain's coming, but in our ever-prevalent mission of avoiding homework or projects or even just real life, our generation has come up with quite the means of distraction. We have Facebook, we have Twitter, we have Instagram, we have Snapchat. However, the biggest distraction for me this year has been BuzzFeed, which is a website where you can take a plethora of online quizzes that determine anything from what color of aura you have to which cartoon character would be your best friend. So in between finding out which Beyonce song best describes my personality and which 90s movie I am based off of my zodiac, I'm not lying, these are actual real quizzes that I've taken. I came across a quiz entitled, What Grade in Life Are You Getting? And it made me wonder, if I could evaluate my experience here at the University of Rio Grande, what grade would I give it? So, I've prepared a quiz for you all. All right, first question. What is your favorite activity outside of class? 2 a.m. trips to Hardee's? Weekend spent at the Bob Evans Farm Festival? Fishing with friends at Tycoon Lake? Attending events that Dina sends you 25 emails about every single day? Or free hugs from Cindy in the cafeteria? Next question. What do you look for in a best friend? Someone who will pull an all-nighter with you just to go to said 2 a.m. Hardee's trip? The senior citizen who strikes up a random and potentially awkward conversation with you in the cafeteria? Someone who will watch your PowerPoint 5 times, even though every time the only change is a comma? Or a bestie who takes notes for you when you just can't quite make it to that 8 a.m.? What is the state of your dorm room or apartment right now? I should probably file a few maintenance requests. The bookstore had a sale. Where's David Ding? I have clothes everywhere. I should really return those filthy dishes that I borrowed from the cafeteria last semester. Or I'm all packed up and ready to check out, which is not me because I haven't moved a single thing out of my dorm room yet. What has been your biggest accomplishment thus far? Intramural basketball champions, duh. Surviving organic chemistry. Immersing yourself in another culture by studying abroad in Wales. Or being the first person in your family to graduate from college. A genie comes and grants you 3 wishes. I wish for a 5-gallon bucket of cookie dough ice cream. I wish for more days where I don't have to change out of my sweatpants. I wish that our faculty and staff knew how much we appreciated them. I wish that the future Red Storms knew all of the great experiences that they are about to have over the next couple years. Now, obviously, I have no algorithm of really giving you a grade for your quiz. However, I know that there are a few components that each of us experienced during our time here at Rio. We've gained confidence in our academic capabilities. We've gained wisdom from the support of our faculty, staff, and administrators. We've gained patience from that girl in the laundry room who was finishing up her 4th load. And we've gained appreciation for the sacrifices that each of our families have had to make for us to be where we are today. But most of all, we have gained lifelong friendships. Friends that have seen us at our best, at our worst. On Saturday night at 11 p.m. and Monday morning at 8 a.m. I don't think I could ever be able to put a numeric value on my experience here, because so far it's been priceless. And I know it's easy to get bogged down by the unknown. What's going to happen next? I don't already have a job waiting for me somewhere. How am I ever going to finish paying off these student loans? There are innumerable I don't know circulating right now, but there's one thing that I'm absolutely certain of, and that is that coming to this small and wonderful campus have made you all smart, courageous, independent men and women that you are today. And because of the A-plus experience that the University of Rio Grande gives us, there is not a doubt in my mind that each and every one of you are ready to travel into the great unknown and charter the mystery that is the next step. Congratulations again, class of 2016.
As Megan joins me, I do want to say one thing, that I believe that the passion and the love that you have for Rio single-handedly may be more than all of the rest of us added together. Thank you for the role model that you are for alumni everywhere. Thanks.
As a member of the University of Rio Grande Alumni Association, I bring you congratulations, best wishes, and welcome from its more than 10,000 members. You have our congratulations for the accomplishment which we are recognizing today. This commencement is a symbol of all that you have achieved and marks the beginning of what you must now be contemplating. You have our best wishes that you will continue to grow and achieve throughout your lives, just as you have grown at Rio Grande. We will continue to rejoice in your success. You have our welcome to the family of Rio Grande alumni. We have all shared the experience. We have sat where you are now. Those of us who left 10, 20, 50, or more years ago realize how much Rio will always be with you. It has been a part of my life since I was a child, and I would not change it. We hope that you are not strangers. Please become involved and be an active alumni member. Your family here at Rio will always be here to support you. Again, congratulations and welcome to the Rio Grande alumni family.
It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day.
Thank you to the Grand Corral for that. The University of Rio Grande and Rio Grande Community College regard the graduation exercise as the most important occasion of the academic year. This has been a momentous and a historic event. It's been fun as well. We are grateful for your presence. We congratulate our graduates and families. Please, graduates, remember to thank your family and your friends for their support. And now, will the audience please rise for the benediction and remain standing during the recessional? We ask those of you currently seated in the circle, and I see it's already cleared. Wonderful. Please remain standing in position until the graduates have completed the traditional circle on the green. At that time, you may join them in singing the alma mater, which is printed in your program. Following the alma mater, please join us for refreshments near the Alumni Memorial Bell Tower, where you will also enjoy hearing the alma mater played by alumna Miss Sabrina Hurt. I ask now that Chaplain Finch offer the benediction to conclude today's ceremony.
Let us join our hearts in prayer. Oh, Father, there is none like you, nor there any greater than you. Therefore, we commit this time, this graduation, these students to you. And Father, may your hands continue to be upon them and upon Rio Grande. We say all these things in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and amen.
Madam President.
Mr. Grand Marshal, the purpose for this assembly has been completed. We await your assistance to retire.
Okay, just what we had, and you folks.